Good morning. So today we look at saturation mixing ratios, and then we'll define relative humidity, saturation mixing ratio, and then dew point, frost point, and all this. And let's go through the formal definitions, and then we'll see how to place all this, put all this on the SKU-T ln P chart, and then go to some little bit advanced concepts like lifting condensation level, which will help you determine the height of the base of the clouds and so on. Okay. Which will correspond to what will be the relative humidity at that condition? 100, it's fully saturated. So you'll have to look for some, you have to look for the air parcel getting 100% saturated. So we'll see how to get that using the charts. You can get all these using formula, but it will be very tedious. Chart will be very helpful. So a little bit approximation will be there, but it's okay. Chart is pretty fast. Now we already looked at the saturation vapor pressure yesterday, and the saturation vapor pressure increases with temperature. We saw that, okay, and after that we looked at the solution to the quiz problems. Okay, we solved the 5 problems, which involved the concepts which we studied in the first 6 or 7 weeks. Now we'll move on. Saturation mixing ratio. Given by omega, yes, omega is mixing ratio, omega subscript S means omega subscript saturation. Omega is given by mv by md, no? Mixing ratio. MV plus MD is specific humidity. Both may be equal, that is a different, nearly equal, that is a different story. What is this? MSAT. So please take down the definition. The saturation mixing ratio omega S. The saturation mixing ratio omega S is given by the ratio of, the saturation mixing ratio omega S is given by the ratio of the mass of the water vapor. The saturation mixing ratio omega S is given, is defined, what did I say? Is given by the ratio of the mass of the water vapor that is saturated, mass of the water vapor that is saturated in a given volume of air. The mass of the water vapor that is saturated in a given volume of air to the mass of dry air. So it is given, defined by the ratio of the mass of water vapor that is saturated in a given volume of air to the mass of the dry air. Mathematically it is given by equation 2, omega S equals M sat by, just take 2 minutes, both M sat and MD follow the ideal gas equation, because MV is also vapor, water vapor is very much an ideal gas. So apply the ideal gas equation, you will get the dry, the gas constant for dry air RD, you will get the gas constant for water vapor RV, you also know the ratio of RD and RV, which will be epsilon. So manipulate that and simplify the expression for omega S. Okay. So that is problem number, special effects. Problem number 28. Okay. when I mean simplified, I have to qualify this. I am looking for something which is more meaningful or easier to calculate, because if it is, I want it in terms of the pressure, because pressure, if you know height, you know pressure. So with height, we can get many things. So pressure and height are the two most, pressure, height and temperature, the two important quantities. So we want to be able to reduce this to that. Correct? It is both are occupying the same volume V. Don't say V1, V2 and all that, mess it up. Something should be constant. The volume is, for this I will use MSAT. Temperature is the same. Very good, okay. I am applying both for the water vapor as well as for the dry air. Okay. Equal PSAT. So we'll just write it RV. All right. I am writing this again and again so that at least a revision, so it gets strengthened. We will never forget this. So therefore, can you simplify this further? What is PD? P minus? Very good. So why P is approximately equal to PSAT? This is applicable for the range of temperatures in the Earth's atmosphere. We are not talking from 0 Kelvin to 5000 Kelvin, 220, 40, 60, 80 of that order. P is much, much greater than PSAT. Okay. at a given temperature. So what is this now? Let us not lose track of this. This fellow is equal to omega S. Very good. Saturation mixing ratio is equal to saturation mixing ratio. At a given temperature, what is the relationship between omega S and total pressure P? Inversely proportional, very good. Omega S goes as 1 over P, correct? What about the relationship between P sat and temperature? What happens as temperature increases? P sat increases. How do we know? Yesterday we have seen. So P sat is a function of T. Omega S goes inversely with pressure. P sat is a function of T. Omega S is a function of both P sat and P. Therefore, omega S is a function of T and P. So, two variable problem. Okay, therefore, very important. So, if you want to work out formula, it will be messy. It is easier to use charts. Okay. Where are the saturation mixing ratio lines? Oh, I have taken some highlighter. It's okay, nice. Oh, huh? Saturation mixing ratio, correct? 40. Is it 40 or what is it? 0.4. No, I don't think it's 0.4. Is it 0.4? 0.4. Oh, that 40, 50 is the other line. So it is here, 0.4. Okay, 1, 2, 5, 10. So the saturation mixing ratios are going up like this. What about the dry adiabats? Dry adiabat. All these fellows are dry adiabats. Okay? Already you know the isotherms, isobars, isotherms. What have I not explained to you so far? Saturation adiabat. That is, we have to see that now. Okay? So please note the saturation mixing ratio is going, their straight lines going from what is that, sloping and left upwards, whatever. Is it okay? We'll revisit this. I don't know how to clean this up. We can go to the next sheet afterwards. Okay? We have some more terminologies. Next is an important concept: relative humidity. Symbol is usually short form is RH. What do you think relative humidity is? If the mixing ratio for a corresponding pressure and temperature is omega, and for that temperature and pressure the saturation mixing ratio is omega S, then omega divided by omega S into 100 will give you relative humidity in percentage. That means if it is fully saturated, omega equal to omega S. So omega S divided by omega S into 100, relative humidity will be 100%. So relative humidity for completely dry air is 0. Relative humidity for fully saturated air is 100. It is varying from 0 to 100, but we all already saw that omega itself or omega s can be only in grams per kg, 5 grams, 10 grams, 20 grams. It can't be 500 grams per water vapor, cannot hold that, the water cannot hold so much. So, that is why the best unit is for omega is grams per kg, all right, okay, RS. Can we also write it like this? It's possible because the total pressure is the same P for both the cases. Okay. So if I give you the vapor pressure and the saturation pressure, you can get the RH. If I give you the omega and omega S also, you can get the RH. Dew point temperature. Please take down the definition of dew point temperature. Ready? The dew point temperature TD TD is the temperature to which air must be cooled. The dew point temperature TD is the temperature to which air must be cooled at constant pressure. Is the temperature to which air must be cooled at constant pressure for it to become saturated. Temperature to which air must be cooled at constant pressure for it to become saturated, for it to become saturated with respect to a plane surface of pure water. Dew point temperature is the temperature to which air must be cooled, okay, at constant pressure. You have to follow an isobar for it to become saturated with respect to a plane surface of pure water. So RH is actually can you write it in terms of dew point? What is that? Please hit the bullseye. What is that? It is omega S at TD and P. It will be fully saturated at that temperature. If it is cooled, that is how much should be the air cooled such that it becomes fully saturated at that pressure. Are you getting the point? If you decrease the temperature, relative humidity goes up. Okay, if you keep on decreasing till the relative humidity becomes 100%, that point, that temperature is called dew point. Understand? If you keep on heating air, what happens? The relative humidity decreases. So, suppose the temperature, let's talk about Chennai now, September, today is September 17th, assuming that the temperature changes by a few degrees centigrade during the day, relative humidity will be more in the morning or in the afternoon? So you will feel more sticky at 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock, rather than evening 2 o'clock or 3 o'clock. You may feel uncomfortable at 2 o'clock for some other reason. The humidity, the stickiness will be very, if it is warm and it is very humid, you will feel very uncomfortable when you go for the A slot, B slot or C slot. Okay? So, relative humidity in tropical or some countries like us can be. So, the 10 o'clock sun is very, is much more uncomfortable than the 3 o'clock sun. Okay? So, let us write this. I am not going to write 10 o'clock sun and all that. So, this I am going to write. So, I am going to write, please help me, 100 omega s, not TDP man, that is something else. Okay, don't get reminded about home, which got split recently. Okay, omega s at TDP divided by omega at TP. Okay. I will give you some simple rule of thumb which you should not use in the exam. Okay. So, what I am giving now is practical meteorology, quick this thing, okay, not for rigorous study. When the relative humidity is greater than 50%, okay, the dew point increases . The simple rule of thumb is the dew point increases by 1 degree centigrade for every 5% decrease in RH. Now, I am going to ask you a simple question. If you answer that, I know for sure that you understood. If you do not know the answer to that question, you have not understood this today's lecture. Okay. At 100% RH, TD and T are one and the same. Okay. So, TD, using this rule of thumb, problem number 29. Using the simple rule of thumb, problem 29, using the simple rule of thumb, determine the difference between the actual temperature and the dew point temperature. Using the simple rule of thumb, determine the difference between the actual temperature and the dew point temperature for an air parcel. Determine the difference between the actual temperature and dew point temperature for an air parcel whose RH is 80%, 80, for an air parcel whose RH is 80%. Very good. Okay. I want all of you to get that 4 degrees. Who will be higher? Who will be lower? TD will be lower. So, immediately in air conditioning, people will ask, what is the dew point of that? What is the dew point in this situation? Okay. So, the dew point itself is a measure of human comfort in warm and humid climates. Okay. So 29. All right. Next, beyond dew point, if the water becomes ice, so there is something called frost point. So you have to, though it is impossible to discuss about frost point in a city like Chennai. Okay, for Germans, frost point has meaning. Chennai is hot, hotter, hottest. But there is a definition, so you have to understand what frost point is. Okay, next one is frost point. Please take down. Frost point is the temperature to which, or frost point colon, temperature to which dry air must be cooled. Temperature to which dry air must be cooled at constant pressure. Temperature to which, sorry, temperature to which air must be cooled. Oh, I am very sorry. Dry air, then it surrender. Temperature to which air must be cooled, I stand corrected, temperature to which air must be cooled at constant pressure to saturate it. Temperature to which air must be cooled at constant pressure to saturate it with respect to a plane, with respect to a plane surface of pure ice, with respect to a plane surface of pure ice. I come again. Frost point, temperature to which air must be cooled at constant pressure to saturate it with respect to a plane surface of pure ice. Now, let us solve a problem. You have to pull out your SKU-T lon-P chart. Okay, this will be the first exercise involving some fundas, what you have learnt in today's class. So, we will build on this in tomorrow's class and subsequent classes. Problem 30. So, by the way, once frost point is defined, you can define the relative humidity, saturation, mixing ratio, all this with respect to ice instead of water. But unless otherwise stated in this course, in atmospheric thermodynamics course generally, relative humidity and saturation mixing ratio are always with respect to water. Very, very cold countries, when you are discussing such kind of thermodynamics, then you can discuss it with respect to ice. So, ice is not at all a consideration for us. Okay. Now, 30. Air at 1000 HPa. Air at 1000 hectopascal, air at 1000 HPa and 27 degrees Celsius, air at 1000 HPa and 27 degrees Celsius has a mixing ratio of, determine the RH, that is determine the relative humidity and the dew point of air. Determine the RH and the dew point of air. Hpa, 27 degrees centigrade, mixing ratio 10 grams per kg, determine RH.
4.3.
Huh? What is 4.3?
RH.
Why don't use the rule of thumb?
Not using.
Just wait. So, please work. I'll give you a couple of minutes. So, I'll get this sorted out and I'm going to show the result on the this thing, and then we will stop. We will complete this problem and stop for today. First, locate the point and call it as point 1 and put it as T and P. So, problem 30. Okay, so the question is clear. Given T is 27. Okay, so shall we solve now? Okay, first locate the 1000. 1000 is here, 1027 degrees. Where are the isotherms? These are the isotherms. Okay, minus 20, minus 10, 0, 10, 20, 30. So, 20 to 30, I am somewhere here, correct? Okay. Very good. That is our point. Any doubt, Marius? You got it? You can't see it. No, no. Okay, that's what I'm saying. 1000, the 1000 line. Okay, the 1000 line. So take the 1000 hpa, Marius. I'm explaining to you. Take the 1000 line. Okay, and then take the isotherm. Isotherms are here, right? Minus 20. That is minus 20, minus 10, 0, 10, 20, 27. Okay, it is here, right? We can't make it bigger, no?
Sir, isotherm is not the dotted line.
Not the dotted line. No, sorry, this line. Yeah, I told the solid line only. Now it's okay. No, it's okay. It is small, that's what. Okay. Now, what is omega S for this situation? No, 22. 25 are you getting? Which is omega S, saturation mixing ratio? So, those are the dotted lines. 0.4? 1, 2, 5, 10, 20, this is 40, yeah? How much is this? 25. Okay, 24. Let us take compromise candidate. Okay. 24 gram per kg. Okay. Therefore, RH. About 41.7%. Very nice. Is it good? Now the important part is coming. I want to find out the dew point. Okay. Please go to the definition of dew point. Dew point temperature TD is the temperature to which air must be cooled at constant pressure for it to become saturated with respect to a plane surface of pure water. I come again. The dew point temperature TD is the temperature to which air must be cooled at constant pressure for it to become saturated with respect to plane surface of pure water. Air is having 10 grams per kg. The funda now is, what will be the temperature at which 10 gram per kg will actually be the omega S for the pressure 1000 bar? I will come again. So, the funda is, what will be the temperature at which this omega of 10 grams per kg will become omega S itself, but what is the other coordinate? Pressure is 1000 hpa. So, along the same pressure horizontally, you have to move towards the left. Correct? So, you move towards the left like this. I got 13 or 14. Okay. So, you go like this. You are reaching 10? 10 is the saturation. Saturation mixing ratio is the dotted line. Okay. What is the temperature for this? Now, temperature, you have to be careful. Temperature is a solid line. So, it requires a lot of skill to, let us do that. How much is this? Minus 20? Minus 10, 0, 10, 20, okay. So, this is 10, this is 20, we are here. So, take your pick. Okay, okay, agreed. So TD. Okay, all that I can ask, we can actually, you can give temperature, pressure, and one of the temperature and pressure, and one of the saturation, one of the moisture parameters to completely fix. For example, I can give temperature is 27 degree centigrade, pressure is 1000 hpa, dew point is 10 degree centigrade, for dew point is 13 degree centigrade, find out what will be the relative humidity and find out what will be the omega. Okay, so there are various ways of, so from dew point also we can proceed. Alright, so all are not independent. Dew point, omega, omega S, all the three are not independent. There is some coupling. Are you getting the point? T and P are basically different. They are not moisture parameters. Then beyond that you require one moisture parameter. Okay, is it fine? So, we are able to use everything. There is one thing which we have not used, I will again mark it, that is the saturation adiabat. It's not a great this thing. During an adiabatic, next class, during an adiabatic process, the dry air follows a dry adiabat. The moist air will follow a, that's it. Thank you.